what I want about you. I'm like overdog. I treat you like I'm Jigga, watch I own it all. Oh, you worry about a critic, that ain't protocol.
It's another one. We got another one. It's her. Who that? Big baby slot. Ooh, in that drop top. Something by Benz looking cute. That's fine as her and her friends. Big blinks and snatch waist. Yeah, she brought the. Ain't no way somebody daddy ain't gonna give her the spins with her ends. Cause yeah, she did it. She did it again. A few more tracks and this time she bought friends. Big baby on her way up and showed the stats.
Today, it's the National Football League. It's week 14 of the NFL on EA Sports. Philadelphia Eagles taking on the Washington Commanders.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Today, it's a Week 14 matchup that should be a good one between the Washington Commanders and the Philadelphia Eagles. Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
Taking in at the three. And able to get this out to the 25. So out comes the Washington offense onto the field. And led out by their veteran quarterback. He's been around a while. They don't celebrate birthdays for him. They just cut him up, see how many rings he's got around the middle. He has been in the league a long time.
And he's had such a sensational season to this point, leading the NFL in passing yards. He's been helped out a lot by an outstanding set of receivers, and he's quick to give them credit. But I think even they would tell you that he's the guy that makes this offense go.
Rich. A contested ball here, and it's going to be caught. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. So the PI decline, and that'll give him a fresh set of downs.
And when you scout tight ends, one thing you want to know, just how strong they are. And we saw it in evidence there. He was able to fight through all the contact and still secure the football.
And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down. Now this defense for the Eagles, they really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there. And they came away with 3 interceptions in that game.
Another run for Brown on second down. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go down as a loss of 5. And it brings up third down.
an interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On third down, Rich. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. And the Eagles are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover.
Here we go, here we go!
So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them and an absolute shock for the quarterback, because he went into it, he saw the numbers we saw, he watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day, and it very well could be, but early in this one, advantage defense.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And the stiff arm made it a pretty little run. Not a huge gain, but a nice chunk of yardage. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. He's going to try and take off with it. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. Boy, the pursuit there, terrific from the linebacking core.
Oh, it certainly was, because so many times on an option play, you'll see a linebacker make a beeline for the quarterback and then zip, one cut, and he's grasping at air. But this time, he locked in on him the whole way, took an excellent angle, and his grasp came up with the quarterback.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Now Williams on third down. He finds his man complete. That's Ellis. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
The Eagles send out their punter now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. Here's Thomas on the return. They'll call it a punt of 44 yards. The return was for 7. And they will take over first and 10. The Commander's going to retake the field for drive number 2. They were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And that's how you shake off the interception you throw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to 2 people on this one, the man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Off the play fake, Rich. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line. And the Eagles are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
Well, your first drive of the first quarter, you get it down there, trying to fire it in the end zone, and big-time deflation on that play.
No doubt about it. They're moving and grooving and getting into position, and this is not the ending that they saw on this drive, is it? They had things going their way.
And as this offense makes their way back out, NFC playoff race time, we give you a look at what's going on there.
A CD, after this game, there will be 4 weeks left in the regular season. So this is far from the final version of what we'll see come January, more of a first draft, if you will, as all these teams fight for a better position.
And you pointed it out so accurately there, Brandon. After this game, 4 weeks left in the regular season, and then the playoffs officially begin. But for some teams trying to fight to make it to the playoffs, they're actually in a playoff push right now.
And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
This, the second meeting between these two division rivals. You might recall they met earlier in the year, and it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home.
Now left side on the swing pass. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
It looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him. They were there, and they tackle him for a loss.
Here's Williams to throw on third down. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Ellis. And the spin looked pretty, but more for style points as the real estate evaporated quickly there. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of 2 there.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know that there's no problem with rhythm. Now, when we're watching offensively, a little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, fun on the first drive, looking at another one here. Just a little slow. And, you know, they were talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, and let's face it, any team we cover always talks about a
That's
fast
true.
Start.
That's true.
But it's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether they're seeing different defenses, they're going to have to figure it out as this game moves on.
That'll be a 43-yard punt, just a single yard on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over.
And the Washington offense heading out.
And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. This will be caught by Brown. 5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5. Off play action, Rich. Steps away to his, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and it goes down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Washington going to send out their punter,
as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Eagles will have it, taking over 1st and 10. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field.
And, partner, I know so far, and we're still in the first half, but you love this game as a defensive guy. 0-0. We'll see if the offense can get going on this drive.
Well, you know how they talk about music to your ears? How about what it does for your eye?
Williams loses the football.
And it's Washington that scoops it up.
And he is going to bring this one back to the house. It's a Commanders touchdown on the scoop and score.
And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz, they dial it up, and it turns into 6 points for them.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice. You're such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
Now the try here for the point after. It's good, and Washington will take a 7-0 lead. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And let's just say they're going to be looking to start over on this drive. A few moments ago, they were in the exact situation, but their first play led to a fumble that was returned for 6.
Yeah, you definitely have to have a short memory to play in the NFL. You got to remember what you did wrong so you don't repeat it. But you can't dwell on it because then you will repeat it. And that's what you don't want to do.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Operating from the gun, Williams working the middle here. That's complete to Knox, the tight end. So it was already a gain on the completion, but tack on some more with that penalty.
Absolutely, and no matter what angle you're making a tackle from, you can't grab the face mask, and that's just putting your defense on its heels just a little bit more.
And now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And tackled down after a gain of 3, leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Give to Reynolds, and he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay? I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the darn ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, third and short, that's what you're supposed to do. Like you said, old school smash mouth football. So first and 10 now from the 30. On the toss, it's Reynolds. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. A quick throw, knocked away and incomplete. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Looking to throw, Williams. It's caught, Smith. And he will not get what he needed as he stops short of the first down at around the 22. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down.
Well, don't tell any defensive coordinator I played for, but that might be considered a win for both teams because defensively they stopped them short and forced the fourth down.
But offensively, they picked up enough yards to give their kicker a better shot, if that's what they want to do.
Blankenship's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And you figure this should be a healthy, arrested, a focused unit, and they're working on a good winning streak. They had the week off last week. This is really a team, Charles, that should be in top four.
I would agree absolutely with that. What coaches worry about, what organizations worry about, though, is overconfidence. They've been playing so well, and now they've had that extra time off. And we've seen teams come back off the open week and come out flat. So what a lot of good coaches do is they kind of game plan for that with their teams. On defense, they may blitz more in the beginning to get them going. On offense, they may go more up-tempo. Anything to get them out of that lethargy right at the beginning.
His first catch, good for 9 and a first down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Back to throw. Rich. There's the stiff arm. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and that'll make it second down.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? 3-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Working with a 2nd and 4. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. On 3rd and 2, Rich, he finds McLaurin. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 40. A strong pickup of 11 keeps their drive alive.
I like the fact that they didn't overcomplicate things on that call. 3rd and 2, just run the quick little hitch, which they did. Ball's out of quarterback's hands, and yes, indeed, they pick up the first down.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10, right at the 40. They'll give this up the middle to Brown, and he gets this to the 35, good for a gain of 5. To throw on 2nd down, Rich. Got a man, it's Brown. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 24-yard line. After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. Here's a give to Brown. A nice little juke. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up 2nd down. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Rich. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. This offense so far on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Looking to throw. Rich, and that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And 4th down now coming up. And his kick is right there. It's good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So a nice kick there as they add 3 to the lead.
And from what I've seen so far, Brandon, I think they've been the better of the 2 teams here in the first half. So even though you want the touchdown, I think that's a nice job there to put 3 points on the board.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. It's Devontae Smith and the Eagles ready to go on offense.
You would have to think they're going to make it more of a priority to get him the football. You're losing here in the second quarter, and he's been really quiet.
I think all we have to do, and it's too bad we can't actually see the actual play sheet now from the coordinator, because he's looking down at that and saying, okay, do I put him in different spots? Do I try and isolate him? What routes do I run? You're exactly right. They've got to get the ball in his hands and get their offense kick-started.
He does have the two catches, but pretty quiet so far. Williams now looking to throw on second down. And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete.
He's second in the NFL in interceptions, and you understand why. He plays a game of great intelligence, understands positioning, and has a great ability to break on the football when it's in the air.
So fun to watch his closing speed, and another example of it on that play. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Back to throw. Williams over the middle, complete. That's Perez. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that
first.
Wasn't the first option.
No, not at all. He came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
To the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A run here with Reynolds. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. They'll run. Reynolds. And not much room to speak of. He'll get about three up to the 41. Williams from the gun on third down, and that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And this is a beauty as that ball's going to angle out at the 6-yard line. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football. They're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They defer to Brown to start the drive. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle. That's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
To throw on 2nd down. Rich, he'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll go down for a loss inside his own 5 at the 4. They'll wind up losing 3 here on the play. And they'll be facing a 3rd and 12. And that screen there on 2nd down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the 1st down on 3rd down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on 3rd down.
So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that 3rd down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is, because he understands how to get open in key situations.
An inside give, Brown. Just a yard on the 1st down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Second and
They keep it on the ground. Again, it's Brown. And he'll get this one up to the 26. To throw on third down, Rich. This to McLaurin out on the left side. And he's going to have a Commanders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And he'll work this one up to about the 38. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Here's Jennings. And the defense on him quickly there as they stop him at the 40 for a gain of just 2. So 2 of 2 on third down conversions on this drive, and now they face a 3rd and 3 here. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. These defenses have become so opportunistic, and no matter what you're playing, in this case, wide receiver, you got to be careful.
Certainly do, because there is a phrase in today's football that we use all the time, completing the process of the catch. Well, it's after you do that where the trouble begins, right? Meaning you've tucked it away, you're trying to get downfield, but someone's always coming up trying to rake in the ball and knock it free.
They'll start on the ground here on first down. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. On the carry, it's Reynolds. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 42 yards. Rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now, here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. And a solid run down inside the 30. Now Williams to throw on second down. He rifles one that's intercepted. There he goes, right side. 20. And he will bring this one back. An interception return for a Commanders touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. No going for two. They'll kick the point after. It's up and good, and that makes it 17-3. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. From a yard or two deep, here comes the return. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. A run here with Reynolds. And he's taken down. It's a gain of three from the 17 to the 20. The Eagles on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 8. Looking to throw. Williams. And this is going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
The Eagles send out their punter now as he's on here to punt it away. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. A 47-yard punt, maybe a couple on the return. And the Commanders will take over with a first and 10. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
This is Brown going up the middle, and he'll push forward to the 37, gain of 2.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
From the gun on third down, Rich fights him off. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Multiple defenders getting to him there for a huge loss.
Like the footwork back there, I thought he did a pretty good job of evading that first wave of players. Tried to buy a little extra time out of the pocket, but in the end, oh, that was a tough one.
Yeah, winds up getting buried for the loss. Washington going to send out their punter as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. That'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly. And it will be Eagles football, first and 10. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. See if they can put this drive in the end zone, Charles, because it's been a little bit of a rough go at times. They've had to punt the football a ton in this ball game because of stalled out drives.
So are you saying that you're kind of tired of seeing the punter run out there and do his thing during this game? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm okay with it. I have a feeling that this offense, they don't want to see the punter again.
And frankly, the punter doesn't want to run out there anymore himself. He'd love to see his offense put together a drive and give his leg a rest.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll check in with Jonathan Coachman from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home. The Eagles hustling to the line, clock rolling. Now a dump off here complete. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. And that is incomplete. The Eagles send out their punter now as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback.
Another drive coming up for this Washington offense.
It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
And not much happening there. He's taken down, but a late penalty flag in the backfield. Now this looks like a roughing call. So roughing the passer penalty, never one that you like to see.
Not at all, and especially when you're in that final push of the season. You can't afford to get your quarterback hurt before the playoffs roll around, and we know they'll be here before you know it.
And Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. On first and 10, Rich. He finds his man complete. It's Townsend. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Looking to throw on second down. Rich. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. 22 yards there. A first down. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Throwing on first down. Rich looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
He'll look underneath and finds Brown. Now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout, as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Here's first and goal, and gosh, points here, a chance maybe to put this thing away before halftime. Back to throw. Rich firing quickly here, and that's complete.
So we have come upon halftime, and it's the visiting group from Washington who are out on top.
As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, we'll get back to you and Charles in a bit. But first, let's get to some of these scores around the NFL here in a busy Week 14. We'll get started down at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. And it's the Cowboys on top as they play the second quarter. The Cowboys trying to gut this one out, as it would be a good victory for them if they could get it. From Miami, we stay in the AFC East and head up to check on the Jets at home at MetLife Stadium. And you can see they trail the visiting Buffalo Bills in that ball game. The Bills trying to hold on and claim victory. Lastly, we head to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough to check on the Patriots. And that one all even as they play the visiting Cleveland Browns. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3.
And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback.
Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter.
And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Looking to throw. Williams throwing the out route and complete. It's Perez. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six. They'll look to throw for it on third and one.
Oh, he tries to force it in and it's intercepted. And the Commanders are going to take possession of the football.
As they started that drive, I think they looked at the scoreboard and said, this is a manageable deficit, guys, but let's go ahead and start cutting it down right here. Instead, an interception happened, so a two-possession game might become three. So as we get going here in the second half, this could rapidly reach the point where there isn't enough time left for a comeback if their defense doesn't bail them out.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Handing it off to Brown. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. Another run for Brown on second down. And he'll go down at the 28. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
On first down, Rich. He finds his man complete. That's Brown.
And he's going to get this down near the 25.
To throw on second down, Rich. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time.
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. Back to throw. Rich. And that is incomplete. Fourth down now looming after Philly's defense stands tall in coverage.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
And his kick here is good. And that will extend their lead even further.
Whatever was said in the locker room during the break must have worked. They forced the turnover. They didn't get the touchdown, Charles, but it does translate into 3 points to begin this second half.
Exactly as they discussed in the locker room at halftime. Get some points to get things kick-started. Now start your half off with some momentum. Gives you something to build on for your next possession.
Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
A good gain on first has them set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. Here's Reynolds, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. 2 yards, good enough for first.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
right back to him on first down. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Here's Williams looking to throw on second down. Flushed out right. Gets past one man. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
He certainly isn't looking at the scoreboard out there, because to me, all he's concerned about is analyzing the field and making most of the time left in this game. Deficit's still there, but he's starting to hit them with some big plays.
In search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Looking to throw. Williams. Oh, the Commanders are going to get there as he's taken down. The sack recorded. It's a loss of 5, and now it's second down.
They were trying to set up a screen there, but that one just too slow in developing.
Yeah, too slow in developing and well read, because that ends up being a bad feeling for the quarterback. When he's got no blocking in front of him, his guys are just going to let defenders go, and they're coming for him. So if it's not there, you just got to throw the ball at the turf at your running back speed.
Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Back to throw. Williams. He'll get this into the hands of Morton. And they're going to get this up to midfield. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on third down.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner. And I don't think, with 3 scores down in the third quarter, they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly.
The Eagles send out their punter now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. On the return. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. The Washington offense set to take over again.
And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
They give it to Brown. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. He finds his man complete. That's Townsend. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
Here's a quick throw caught out wide. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe.
Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Williams now throwing on first down. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. He couldn't get rid of it. He takes his sack for a loss of six to bring up second down.
It has been a rough afternoon for him trying to get rid of the football. See, that's now five sacks.
How'd you like to be the offensive coordinator, the offensive line coach, trying to come up with an answer for this pass rush? What blocking assignments do you change? Can guys play a little bit better? And we're seeing the end result on the scoreboard. Long day in the pocket for their quarterback.
On second down, it's Ellis. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Escaping the pressure right. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Well, he and his offense were staring down what was likely a three and out. Zero fear from his side, though. Never doubt for a second they pick up the first. He's ready to pull the trigger on a keeper the moment it revealed itself.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Looking to throw. Williams. This is Smith with a grab. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. They give him a gain of 37.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Back to throw. Williams. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Dawson Knox with career touchdown number 70. And the Eagles get a bit closer.
That's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, gotta give him credit, found the perfect play call. Quarterback let it fly as soon as the target came free, and his guy made a nice catch. Just how you draw it up in practice and then execute it in the game.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and the lead is trimmed down to 10. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. Fielded just outside the goal line. Washington ready to try again on offense. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in the second half. Got it here at the 29 on second and 8.
Operating from the gun, Rich. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, They almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
On first and 10, Rich
throwing it Terry McLaurin's way again, and he's got it. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line.
And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Throwing on first down, Rich. He finds his man complete. That's Brown.